As we said, like even if there is a one member also, we will continue the training and we'll go ahead with the schedule. So today we will be covering the SigFit module. So it is a very small process actually. So it should not take a long time for us. Morning we had covered in Hindi. So broadly speaking, it contains the process starting from the OPD or IPD doctor, where when a patient requires certification, a Sick certification. So that can be initiated by the doctor from the doctor desk. And then that request will appear in the centralized desk, which will be operating the SickFit certification. So SickFit cell will see the list of all the patients for whom the recommendation for the Sick certification has been generated by the doctors. So that list, the desk will update if any further details have to be updated. So after that, a report gets generated there. We will be able to cover various scenarios that will come in this process. So whether it is a Sick initial Sick certificate, whether it is a Sick extension, or the fit certification, IOD, transfer, fit for travel. So all those scenarios we will be able to cover. So, but however, the whole process will be on the same lines. So it is a simple process coming initiated by the doctor and then handled at the SickFit cell. So once this process is completed, the certificate gets generated that can be printed and that can be issued to the patient or to the administrative authorities. So this is how the whole process will happen. So let us get into the demonstration. We will also have the interactive session immediately within this session itself, because morning session we had an extended discussion, so we will not have another session for the interactive thing at 4:30. So we will try to cover the discussions as part of this session itself. So at the end of the session, we will have interactive. So let us come to the first aspect of the SickFit certification module. So when a patient visits the doctor in OPD, doctor will have an option here. You can see in the just below the complaints module complaints tab, you have a SickFit label here. If you click on it, so you will be able to see this page, where some of the information automatically comes, like department and episode, and then we have to indicate whether the sick category is a railway sick or an external sick. External sick can mean the private sick, or it can be reasons of like absence on administrative account. If administration asks to give this fitness certification, so in that case, we will choose this category called sick, external sick. And then in the sick type, we will choose various categories like initial sick, whether it is a sick extension, whether an IOD, whether it is a fit certification, fit for travel, IOD fit, IOD sick extension, so interim sick, IOD interim sick. So all these options are there. So we will explain now one by one as we go along. So only difference that we have between railway sick and external sick is that in external sick, we will not generate the sick certification because somebody has felt sick in the external in the hospitals external to the railway chain system. So no doctor is going to certify anything on that sick. Only fitness will be marked here. So that is the difference that will happen with the external SIG. Whereas in the railway SIG, we can have multiple scenarios. So the first scenario will be the initial SIG, and then second time when the patient again comes for the kind of extension of the SIG, so we'll go with the SIG extension. If any IOD is involved, then we will opt the IOD. And if patient requires to be transferred to the original unit for declaring the fitness, so in that case, we can give the fit to travel certification. Then the fitness can happen on a normal course, or it can be on IOD case also, the fitness can be given. So apart from that, interim SIG certification will be required from time to time, because for the payroll authorities to draw the salary during the SIG period, they need a confirmation from the hospital that yes, these people continue to remain on SIG. So that is an interim SIG certification. So based on that, salaries can be drawn by the drawing and disbursing authorities. So for that, we have the option of interim SIG. So let us go step by step. It should start with the initial SIG, and then we will indicate from date and to date. So left side you have a from, and then right side to date, and then after that, who is the doctor advising? Then the sick leave reasons can be the medical treatment or for change of air. So all those possibilities indicated in the medical attendance and treatment rules. So we have captured here, and then we have an option to access EMR straight from here itself. So EMR also can be accessed from here, and then this is all. So only this information have to be fed here, and after that, the doctor will indicate what are all the relevant documents for this particular sick or fit certification. So doctor may be of the view that this patient is belonging to a running category, so sick memo should always follow for these patients to keep on the sick list. So the running categories are operating related sensitive staff. So for them, the sick certification can be issued only if it is coming with the sick memo issued by the controlling officers. So for that, he can indicate the sick memo here, and if any investigation reports, external reports are required, so those also can be indicated here. And sometimes patient declaration also requires, so that kind of declarations also can be added here. So here doctor is not adding or uploading any documents here. Doctor is only just indicating that these are the documents which are relevant for issuing the certificate. So he will see them offline, and he will just tick them here. He will not do anything else. And with that, he can save the option here. So a sick related request gets generated here. So we have a sick list number getting generated here. And when we go to the desk, so sick fit is under a different module altogether. So when we go to the sick fit module, and after the advice has been generated, we need to save the prescription. This is necessary because the sick fit advice is just a one of the option there. After that, the normal treatment that has to be done, normal course of advice has to be given for that patient, that anyway has to be done. So prescription also has to be saved here. So after this, now let us go to the sick fit desk. So we have another module, separate module, sick and fit. So in this, you have only two options here. So the first one will be the sick fit request related thing. So here, patient has to be identified with CR number or UMID number. And then it will automatically display on the top what are all requests that have been already generated for this patient. So from Department of Dermatology, one sick related request, initial sick, sick type, you can see initial sick, that advice has been generated by the doctor, but certification has not been issued as yet. So what we can do, we can click on that entry, that particular episode.
Extension suggest any procedure and where is the
And then if you want to modify details, we can modify. However, we will try to do another transaction here.
Temporary registration చేస్తాను.
రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ అవసరం కాదు ఉంది కదా
సిఆర్ నంబర్
దాంట్లో ఒమిద్ నంబర్ పెట్టేసి
సిఆర్ నంబర్
ఇక్కడ సర్చ్ పెట్టారు కూడా మొబైల్ నంబర్ పెట్టేసి లేదంటే పిఎఫ్ నంబర్ ఏదో 6 8 9 7 6 0 0 1. So here ये तो सीआर नंबर. So here what we have done, there is another process. The sick fit request can come from the doctor through OPD that we have already seen. So another way of initiating the request for the sick fit would be by the sick fit dealer. So there will be a centralized cell in each hospital. It will be manned by a doctor and the clerk. So that clerk also can initiate the request for the sick fit through with reference to an advice coming through offline. So suppose a doctor has just given it in paper. He is not using HMIS, but sick fit module is implemented. So in all those scenarios, so we can select the we can the sick fit dealer also can initiate this transaction here. So here the same set of information will be filled by the clerk on behalf of the doctor, and then he will indicate the checklist documents and all, and then he can save it. So here also again the request gets saved, generating a number. Now coming back to the sick fit module, here you can see the two requests that we have generated today. So they've got they are appearing here. First, so this is the request that has come from the doctor desk. So other case that we've done has been directly initiated by the sick fit dealer. So this will appear like this. Now the information that is required to generate the certificate has been already there. So now to whom this certificate has to be issued, so that we can indicate here who has issued the certificate and who will take all those information can be uploaded. And then apart from that, whatever documents that have been marked for uploading, so those can be uploaded here. Because sick memo can be mandatory in case of the operating staff. Then if somebody is coming on a private sick sick certification, then external certificates also can be uploaded here. Then sometimes self declaration if required, those documents also can be uploaded here. So this is just an uploading option. After that we need to save it. Once this information is saved, so automatically a sick certification gets generated here. So you can see this is coming with a label. The category is railway sick. Then we have the category type as the initial sick. Then rest of the patient related identification information is coming. So we have a validations here that this can be generated only for an employee, not for other people like dependents or pensioners. So it is not relevant. So only for employees it will be valid. Then the running information will come that initial sick has been issued for this patient with so and so information here. So after that, this report can gets generated in PDF format, and this can be either signed by the doctor digitally or by manual means. So if hospital has a practice of getting signature of the patient also, so that also can be taken, and then this image can be This thing can be scanned and uploaded or sent, not uploaded, it can be mailed to the concerned officials. So you can create the group for different controlling officers of the division. Like for operating, you can create a one group of set of mail IDs. The concerned dealer, AOM, DOM, senior DOM. So all of them can be kept under one group, and you can simply upload this document and mail to them. So this commission can be established. If you if a hospital is convenient by sending these certificates by physical means, so that also can be followed. So it is up to them how they want to deal with it. But certificate generation is the process that we are covering it here. So now we have completed the initial six certification process. So let us see for the same patient. So if he wants to print this certificate again for some reasons, then we can click on this option. So here you will have the print option available here. So again, you can print the same document. So reprint option also is available here. So now if we have to initiate another process for this patient for sick extension or something, then again we can go to the SickFit request, and we will enter the CR number. Now you can see, so one entry of the initial sick has already come on the top. So now we can change the category here. So we will change the sick type now from initial sick to sick extension. So you can indicate the dates here. And then the same set of information, you can give a special remark. Sometimes you can say somebody at the time of field certification, normally special remarks can be relevant. So you can indicate somebody's but only to be kept on light duties for some time. So that kind of remarks you can give at field certification. We'll come back to that. So now we are giving a sick extension here. So again, we will save it. So time is overlapping here, so we can change the time. So here now another this number is generated here. It is actually the same number. So if you go back to the again second field certificate page here, and if you select the case, now you will see the two entries here. So wherever you have a blue dot, it means it requires some action. Wherever there is a gray button there, it means the action is already completed. And the print icons also convert from red to green once the action is completed. So now we can select the blue button here. And here you can update to whom this certificate is being handed over. If it is a patient, you can select the patient. Or if you are handing it over to the relative, so that also you can select and enter the details. Then the reference numbers. Right now we kept the reference numbers manually because you might be having a running registers. Until you completely come over to the HMIS 100%, so probably we may need to have this manual numbers intact. So that's why we kept it open. Later on it will become a system generated numbers. So again, if you want to upload some document, you can upload. Otherwise, you can save it. Now the sick extension related certificate also gets generated here. So now you will be able to see category as railway sick, but certification type as a sick extension. So here the period also is coming from 2nd November to 3rd November, you will be able to see. So this is a sick extension certificate. And for the same patient, suppose you are you want to make a fit. So it is a complete cycle from initial sick to the final fit certification. So this is a complete cycle. Then the cycle completes and then your new episode can be started again. So for this fit certification, as I said, we can give a special remarks. So even on becoming fit, somebody needs to be kept under some light duties. So those things can be indicated here. Now the same request number is shown here. So if you go back to that case, a fit certification also might have got generated here.
Current sick leave from NC, old sick leave.
Right. So now we need to migrate, change over from current sick list to the old sick list or fit list. So this patient now is turned up into a fit list, not in the sick list. So the blue dot is there on the fit certification. So we can click on it and you can indicate the handing over details here. And you can save this. So now the fit certification gets generated here.
Period of first initial sick.
So it will show basically the period of sick from 1st November to the 4th November here. And he has become fit and so on 4th. So the this is all in this, we will have some other scenarios. Apart from the normal sick, somebody can be if there is an IOD involved, so in that case we can So we are checking with another case here, where we will indicate we have an initial sick already generated, but however here we will try to choose a different. Suppose an IOD is involved here, so we can indicate IOD. So IOD is nothing but just flagging a patient that he is under sick list, but IOD is involved. Nothing much is changing here. The rest of the process about the injury details being analyzed or investigations that have to be done by the welfare inspector, then the committee to follow up and decide about the disability. So all of that will happen parallel to this. So it has nothing to do with the fit and sick certification here. So in case of IOD, we have some more details coming up. So injury reason, injury site, injury type, date and time of accident or incident. So place of incident. So all those information we can indicate here. And after that, same the upload options will be there, and then we will save it. So in case of IOD, at the time of initiating a stage itself, we have to indicate there. So IOD sick certification and IOD sick extension, both are different. So here in case of a patient, the initial sick has been already generated. So for that IOD, choosing an IOD means that IOD is also again initial sick. So two initial sicks are getting conflicted here. So that's why system has thrown an error. So we can take the initial sick on a normal course, and then we can give the IOD sick extension. And we can indicate the all the details related to the injury, IOD. Okay. So so the remaining all process will be the same thing. So only for some categories of sick type, we have a different details coming up, but rest of all the formats are all mapped accordingly. And we can have a different reports coming up for this. So we can we will try to identify what all reports are normally required. So this one general type of reports that are required is the sick list report, the fit list report. So that kind of reports are already there. But apart from that, you might require a lot of reports on a time basis, periodical reports, how many people from which department, which category, how many sick people are under sick list, how many people are there in the sick list for more than 31 days, so 30 days. So such kind of reports also can be configured here. So we will try to compile the requirements and configure the reports for you. So that is all we have in the Sick Fit certification module. This module is still under some testing mode. We have some instances to be tested. Some validations are yet to be built so that without errors, this thing with a proper consistent data only the system will run. So for that we still require a 1 week time. So for next week onwards, I think module will be available for usage. Meanwhile, what we can expect from you is you can give us the requirements about the configuration of the roles. So which persons need to be given access to the Sick Fit module. So whether it is the clerk or the doctors, the nodal doctor who handles there, along with the backup plan also. Suppose those persons will be on leave, who will be taking care of it? So all those requirements of the users and the module access. So that information can be mailed to us, and we will start configuring these details. And after the validations are all completed in a proper manner, so from next week onwards, this module can be fully implemented. So
What do you think, Jason?
we have done a one case here for the IOD. So all the formats and reports that are there, so we have standardized them, and then we have made them into a uniforms kind of templates.
IOD are your details as well.
So apart from the sick related information in IOD certification, you will also have some more details like this. What is the nature of injury, place of accident, date and time of accident? So such information will be coming here. So since these are all like locally printed formats that are in usage, so there can be slight changes in the formats or design. But however, for HMIs, we will be having a common format here. So now we will keep the session now open for discussion. So